Your son Rhys, 19 years old, went missing in the summer, and then 2 weeks later he was found dead.
And I started getting phone calls and that night. I still wasn't him. People said, you know, you're not going to see your boy again. He's been setting fire and that. And people were texting me saying, I'm sorry about your son, about what you mean. And I've got to live still, and I can't. I just need to know what happened.
And we're on. Today's guest, we've got Stephanie Bonner. First of all, Stephanie, I just want to say thanks for coming on.
Thank you for having me.
It's a heartbreaking story. Your son, Rhys, 19 years old, went missing in the summer, and then 2 weeks later, he was found dead. You've not had any answers. You're still trying to figure out what happened. So we'll just go right back to when the day that Rhys got found missing. Uh-huh. What was the lead up to that?
It's just... before he got found.
Yeah.
Aye. It was just, we're just looking for him. We just heard, I didn't know where he was. He went out the house to go to McDonald's. He'd left, he was staying with my dad that night, and he got a couple of cigarettes and that, and he said, if you get £10, he had given my dad £20, and he said, can I get £10 off for that and just keep that £10 for my personal? I'm going to come back and watch you sell it, give me after. So we went out at the shop and got himself a wee bottle of cider. He doesn't use a drink, obviously, he must have had some confidence. I know that day he got a piece of house because we stayed in Ballanock, so he doesn't usually go up there or anything, but he had a wee girlfriend up there, and that's where I thought he'd went. And he asked me if you got a fiver. Mum, I'm going up to McDonald's to meet somebody. And that was it. I mean, I met my mum up the hairdressers and all before that as well, and he started walking, and we never, and the Wednesday night, and I came home, and my dad said he never came back to watch football. I said, oh, did he know? I said, that's not like this. I said, he must be still up his girlfriend's house. And I thought, and my mum phoned me that night. She said, he's still no in hen. And the Thursday came, and she went, I can't phone the post a couple of days because of radio and that the noon. Because we still thought he was up at his wee girlfriend's and that. And the Friday came, she went on the phone, and she phoned the police. So I ended up writing on my Facebook page because I was phoning everybody. Nobody heard him, his wee pals and all that. So I ended up writing it on Facebook. I said, anybody seen Maris? Somebody said, I swear. So I'm going, oh, that's great. It must be... a young girl, somebody's sitting in her house or something, and somebody went, going to Google that picture, because look at her, and I Googled it, and I seen the picture here, and I went, oh, and I thought maybe it was where her son's or whatever, my mum that was looking for him, and I told my mum, and I said, he's where a Easter house, I told my mum that where it was, and she told the police went up to Easter house, and my mum said, he's where her, and the police said, oh, we know her, and they says, we're going to kick her door in and that, so when they came back down, I says, don't bring him back now, wouldn't they? And yeah, the police says, she said she's not seen him. So I said, she hangs about the Easter House shopping centre and that. So my sister and that, I came out to put my trainers and that up, on to go up and look for this that day. And my sister and that had already just went up. So I says, did you take your jacket and that up to my mum? She went, I gave your jacket and all that up because it was cold and we did his t-shirt and that one. And she said, and she went up and she said, abuse. And she was stunning there. To her back, and she, my sister tapped her, and she went, have you seen Rhys? And she went, oh no, Rhys, I don't know where Rhys is written. And that she stunned a couple of people, and my sister started crying that. She said, because Rhys is missing and that, and some her pals started saying, tell her, because you've got a nephew yourself, you tell her where that boy is and that. And she's going, is he Italian and that? My sister's going, no, he's not Italian. And she's going, I'm a lesbian, by the way. My sister says, I don't care about you, have you seen my nephew? And she went, well, was at the lock. That's the last place I seen him. My sister's just taking us to a wee park. So my sister was storing, talking to somebody else, and my friend noticed that she started walking away. She's trying to go dead fast, so my friend got in a motor, and she drove down, and she says, going to show me where you stay, and where Rhys was. She went, so she got in the motor with him, and she went round, she went, it was just there, and my sister noticed the size of that and that. So my sister thought maybe like she was hiding or something. She went, gave her the phone number. She went, I think you're going to get me phone calls, Stephanie. I feel he's after to tell you, let you know he's all right. Then I started getting phone calls and that night. Still wasn't him. People said, you know, you're not going to see your boy again. He's been setting fire and that. What are you talking about? She went, that's the kind of person she is. You know, you're never going to see him again. And that's what people were saying to me. And they killed my brother. He's battered my pal with a baseball bat, killed them, and...
And this is this woman. Aye. So your son, when he went missing, apparently she was the last one to be seen with him.
Aye, the CCTV footage, aye.
So was there any beforehand, like, suspicious did Rhys have any enemies or
No, not at all. He was supposed to have been helping her with a bag. Her bag's supposed to have dropped, and that's how he was supposed to have met her. Because Rhys would help anybody, he would take you face value, doesn't he? Would take you talk.
So being 19, was that like being missing for a day or two, maybe at a party or his girlfriend's, was that normal?
One day he's went away and he's contacted me and let me know, listen, I'm here, mum, and that.
Just to let you know.
And I knew he was never, mm. I knew 2 days, I went 2 days, mum, yeah. He's still not back 2 days. I says, what have they done to him? What's she done? If they're not hearing all these stories, I've never heard her in my life.
Did you get that feeling then 2 days later that something was wrong, the gut feeling?
Because I was up shouting him and that. And the bit I was, I started being sick and all that. And a couple of weeks later, that was the bit she came out. Boggan's supposed to be in that. She came out of there. And my son was just yards from there, supposed to be. So I had a feeling, and it must have been, the feeling he was there. It was horrible, and I was being sick and all that, and I took him back down, and the next day I'm up, and her van door was opened, and it was just dead eerie, and it was just dead dark, and we're shouting, Rhys, Rhys, and we're up there shouting, and everybody's up helping us, we're all searching the whole of the scheme, and we started getting posters.
How was the police treat you? When did you start getting in contact with them?
They came out and a couple of days later, they searched the house, and they searched my dad's house and that, you know, just asking us questions that, and they kept on saying, what do you think's happened? I said, I think they've done something to him, and that's all they kept on saying, and just really helpful at all. I felt as if I was a...
You were the...
You were just feeling comfortable. They were going to help me, kind of thing, and... Mm-hmm. It was and every day I'm throwing him, and he's going, we've got this action today, we've got these people to talk to, and he's just going to go and look for him, going to get a helicopter, going to do something. So they had a special drone, they said, so they were all happy with us, trying to tell me this, we've got this special drone, and that's how they end up finding Rhys. That they got her in a few times, how no keep her in at the very start to find out, how did it take 2 weeks to find out where Rhys was? Just why don't you no keep her in, why did you keep on letting her out?
That's a long time, especially for a boy at 19.
Aye, aye.
And how's... So this is one of the reasons why you're on here today, is to try and get answers.
Aye.
You want water or anything?
No, I'm all right, thanks.
So for anybody who's watching us or maybe scared to come forward, or Stephanie's wanting some answers, that maybe aye. You know something that...
It's his last moments. Please. If anybody's seen anything or just...
What kind of... What, is there anybody that came forward to try and help you, or anybody that's maybe seen something? Because a lot of people...
There was another three people involved, and they went back and robbed your son. And that's how his trousers and that are off.
Because he had shorts, was it shorts and T-shirt?
His shorts are missing still, we kind of find him. His trousers were off him, and he just had his boxers on and his T-shirt. He was supposed to be getting stuck in the mud and all that, but when he came and showed me his trousers, that were 20 yards away from him, his trainer was in a tree, as if they'd been through. Then a couple of days later, we were searching for him and that, and my sister found his hat in the next close, and she picked it up, and it was smelling that pure soap powder, dead strong. And people were supposed to have had that hat. She was supposed to have had that one hat. Maybe,
so you think somebody's washed all the stuff?
Aye.
What's forensics then?
They said they can't get it after stuff. That's what they're saying to me.
Because it was in water? 2 weeks?
Aye, they said they no, no about him. They said about his clothes and that, the hat and that. They can't get it after that yet.
Mm-hmm. So for today then, how can people... What would you say to people, for anybody watching that are maybe scared to come forward, that might have information for you?
Oh, please, I'm not going to say it was you. Don't be scared, because you're supposed to be a scary person. Just don't be scared. Just says my son is a child. I don't want it to happen to anybody else. I just make know what happened. Just I'm pained. I mean, it's not fair. I had him when I was 17. I've kept him never. He wasn't in no bell. He wasn't at the doctors or nothing. I kept him safe for my life. And I've got to have to stop him. I can't. I just need to know what happened. Mm-hmm.
Just to get answers. So for anybody, we'll put...
Answers. He's only 19. Was he in pain? Was he wanting me?
We'll put all the links, because you had a Facebook page there.
Aye.
Which also got... That got took down, though.
Aye, got took down, that 11,000 people, and it was only there for 3 weeks.
So you've got some amount of support for yourself.
Aye. Mm-hmm. Everybody's amazing. Everybody really great.
So why did that get took down?
Yeah, because all the things that people were writing about it, what she'd done. All this stuff that I'm shocked, like reading it. I says, she's killed my brother, she's killed this. She's held wee boys hostage in their house. She's supposed to kids on, she sells stuff, lures them up and that, robs them, drugs them up.
And this woman that's apparently
done this with his,
seen your son.
And just, I've had to tell the police everything. I've had to tell the police who was supposed to have been seen with that. And I keep on saying to the police, if you got these people and that, they're out their face, or we can't get a hold of them. I says, I'm wanting about myself, searching their clothes, and I'm seeing these people walking past me in the street. How can you not get a hold of them?
Mm-hmm. When you got, so 2 weeks later, when you got that phone call then to say that the body's been found, he must have been in life just in tatters, shattered.
Oh, it was terrible because I was sitting with my mum, so I just got to go out and search for him, and it was the sergeant that was dealing with his case, and he went, if I find Rhys and I find his body, I went, I'll be the first to, like, you know, I'll come myself personally. So I looked out the window, took his hat off. I said to my mum, oh, he's got to come and tell me. I says, please don't tell me. And he just grabbed me. I fell on him. He said, I found him. And I said, stop talking. I said, you promise me you'll bring him back safe.
So, you might get some water, still get some of that water stuff. Because, listen, obviously, it's still.
How'd you get on with that? Everybody I put the plate, he used to take his wee sisters now out, and everybody was dead. He was a gentleman. He was lovely. He was a wee soul. Lovely boy.
Listen, I know it's still raw for you and still fresh, and for you to come on the day.
I just want answers for him, get your story
because
sisters and brothers.
This is your first Christmas and stuff as well. So,
because my mum and dad, they're struggling because I don't know, 17. I said to my mum, it was a big help. My mum teach me to be a mum to him. Mm-hmm. She helped me, and she was amazing.
Because you've got other kids, because I've spoke to your family in the living room, they're great people, they clearly support you. Especially in this difficult time, it doesn't matter what I'm saying.
I had to bring that coffin back, and I had to sit in that coffin, and I love him. My son's coffin, his favourite songs, that pop songs that playing.
Why did the police release the body so quick? Usually they can hold it.
See, he was coming up to tell me that he had passed away, do you know, that was on Facebook, and people were texting me saying, I'm sorry about your son, about what you mean? And he was walking in, it was on straight away. I had to say, going to please do an appeal, going to. Right, so a week later, they wrote it on Facebook, then two weeks later, I was missing for 2 weeks, I said, are you going to do another one? He went, oh, well, we're just thinking about doing that, then he put another appeal on. How's he not done it? How's he not done an appeal saying, has anybody seen anything or anything? Mm-hmm. A young 19-year-old boy just need to take his own clothes off and go and hide in a ditch right out the way.
What do you think then? What do you think the answers are? What do you think you've got so far that you know that maybe the police aren't doing? Do you think there's something getting hid back, or do you think there's just lack of evidence?
I've made a mess of it.
Or do you think there's just lack of evidence?
We gave a phone, it was all smashed, it was found up there, and we thought it was her, it threw it away. So we gave this to the phone and all that. The police, and 5 months later, because when I went to the son, that's when she started phoning me and saying, oh, is everything all right? And she says, right, give me the names now. She went on my way to try and get people and all that. And then she said, but then you could tell they were trying to do something. They went, I said, why are you doing it 5 months later? Why go and see all the people straight away to see what they were like then? They've had 5 months to make up excuses and stories and things and everything.
It's heartbreaking. And again, we've spoke before, it's no, people always say time's a healer. Time's never a healer. It's you adapt to the pain. You learn to deal with it. So we'll put all the links in the bio for people to get in contact with. We'll leave a phone number, we'll leave an email address, we'll leave everything for anybody that's got answers to.
My kids are scared as well. My son's covers out there, do you know what I mean? What about nobody coming forward. He was walking about up there, do you know what I mean? Everybody must have been walking about. It was a lovely day. It was Wednesday, 24th of July. Celtic got my plane in Europe. It was a lovely summer's night. It doesn't get dark to pure late. The place he was going in, the woods bit, everybody cuts through, and it got across Easter House, Blackadder Drive. If you go to your window, because I've been up somebody's house, you can see right onto everything. You can see everything. How did nobody see anything? It was right, it's supposed to be just right. A couple of yards of people's houses, and was he screaming for help? Did you just know?
He would just be constantly mind on repeat.
Was he there for a couple of days in pain? Was he dying? Did you just put him there? Was he not even there? Because a couple of days before he was found, there was two shadows seen. Where Rhys's body was supposed to be. Somebody with a red jacket on, a male and a female, older couple, and somebody told the police this, but the police never got back to them. But they were telling me this, so I told the police this and that.
Listen, I don't want to keep you too long, just keep talking. Is there anything to keep you would want to finish up on that for people to get in contact or for people to try and help you and get some answers for yourself?
I just want to know what happened to him. I really need to know. Please, anybody knows anything at all? Did you see him? Did you see him? Anybody else? Was any male or females? Anybody at all? Anything? Because people said he was still alive on the Saturday night. That was keeping me going. They said they still seen him on the Saturday night. And the police said, no, he was definitely going on the Wednesday. But his body was in some state. I couldn't even go and see it or nothing. And I just I have now getting the post-mortem results, toxicology, 6 months later, do you know what I mean?
Actually, you've still not got the post-mortem results yet, so you don't really know how he passed away. So it's still on your mind, but listen, we'll keep this, we'll put all the links for anybody watching, we'll leave all the links for you to get in contact with Stephanie, we'll also leave a number, so for anybody with information, help the women out and help her and her family get some closure so they can try and get the answers that they need. But Stephanie, listen, God bless you, and
thank you very much.
I'm always here if you need it, you know.
Thank you. Thanks. Cheers.